Hello guys, so this problem is from June Circuits. This is from a running contest. I am gonna create this a video for this problem and would publish only after the contest is over. So let's quickly read the problem statement. So problem statement says that you are given a polygon of n sides with vertices numbered from 1 to n. Now exactly two vertices of this polygon are colored as black and remaining are colored white. So we are required to find the number of triangles denoted by A such that the triangle is found by joining only the white colored vertices of the polygon. And second, the triangle should share at least one side with the polygon. All right. So the input format is that we'll be given certain number of test cases, and then the three the next T lines would contain three space separated integers, and B1 and B2, where n is the number of the sides in the polygon, and B1 and B2 are the vertices which are colored black. What we need to just find is for every case that how many triangles that we can build following these two rules. So for example, here we are given that these numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Although it is not mentioned, but we can assume this, that this numbering of the vertices are consecutive. So once it is marked as 2 and 5 are marked as black, so we cannot use them to make a triangle, and we can make one triangle like this 6. We can build one triangle 6, 1, 4 and 1, 3, 4 here. So I'll try to explain my approach by taking this example, and the solution is totally based on certain observation that you can easily get if you try to draw certain cases and try to see a pattern there. So for example, let's say this polygon which has 9 vertices, and let's say for example I would choose 2 vertices which are adjacent. So let me just mark those 2 vertices which are black, and let me actually use color, because color black is something which is said to be the taken one, and we will not use them already in our case. So now we can only use what is 1 4 5 6 7 8, and this one is also missing, so let me just mark this one as well. This is 9th vertex. All right, so using these, how many triangles we can build? So now one more thing that is given to us is that we cannot build any triangle which does not share any edge with this, with our given polygon. So for example, this triangle is not a valid one, like this 9, 4, 6 is not valid, because to form this triangle we need to basically have 3 new edges, and which is not we are told not to do like that. We are supposed to use at least one edge from the given polygon only. So as you now you understood that this type of triangle is not valid one. So what are the valid ones is that we need to keep at least one of the edges fixed. So for example, if we fix 1 and 9, how many triangles we can build? So we can make this as one triangle. All right, let me choose another color, and then what we can do as well, fixing 1 and 9 only, we can make another triangle here, and then again by fixing 1 and 9 we can make a triangle at 6. Similarly, we can make some triangle at 7. All right, and let me just quickly change the color so that we can distinguish later. So this is another triangle that we can build, and then the last triangle that we can build is this one, 1, 9, 8. So now you can see how many triangles we can form if we fix one edge here, and the answer is the number of vertices which are left after taking these two and the one which are blocked already. So two were already blocked, and once we pick one edge, that means once we fix one edge, there are exactly 2 more vertices which are blocked now. So overall 4 vertices were blocked, and the remaining ones were 5, and so we could build 5 more triangles here. So you can also count 1, 2, 3, 4 and the black one which is 5, 5th one. Yeah, So till now, what we can simply see is that once we fix one edge, we can simply say, then we can count the number of vertices, and that we can discuss later how we can count this number of left vertices, and then the number of triangles that we can form using this particular fixed edge is the number of left vertices. Will that be the case with all the edges which are not blocked by any of these black colored vertices? The answer is no. Why is that case? Let's consider few things here. Let's take this example now, that when we'll fix this 8 and 9 edge, that means the edge formed by 8 and 9 vertices. So what happens there, that we will be able to find new triangles, and those triangles would be like coming from 9, 8 and 4, then 5, then 6, then 7. But what happens here when we pick this one? This one will also be a triangle, but this triangle is already calculated when we were fixing 9 and 1. So if we follow the same rule, that the number of left vertices here, we would add one more vertice into our answer, which will be a duplicate. So we'll have to consider this one, like we will have to avoid calculating this one one more time. And how will we know that? So to answer that, it will always be one vertex which is adjacent to the this edge that we are currently forming. So if we go clockwise here, like keep on checking the edges clockwise, so once we fix 1 and 9, what happens is that for the first one we would be able to pick all the vertices, and then for the next one we would not be able to pick just the previous one, and apart from that we would be able to pick all of them, because we could just see that with 9 and 8 we were able to form new triangles, and with the previous one we will not be, because the previous edge would itself be fixed at some point of time and would have formed the triangle with the current the rightmost vertex here. So for example, if we consider building for this one 8 7, what will happen is that we can form new triangles with all the left vertices, like this one, and similarly with 6, and similarly with 5, and also with 1 here as well, like this 8 1 7 is a new triangle. But we will not, when we will calculate this one, this would have been already this 9 8 7, this would have already been calculated with this one when we were considering this edge, which is 8 9, I mean which is formed by this 8 and 9. So we could clearly see a pattern here, and if we try to observe the pattern closely, we could easily form a formula with the number of left vertices if we block these two. So we can always know how many vertices are here, and I can talk about that in a moment. But for now, let's say the number of left vertices here were x. So for the once we fix the first edge, we would be able to build total x minus 2 new triangles. All right, so this would be the number of triangles once we fix the first edge. What happens once we fix the second edge? So for all the edges, second edge onwards, for the rest of the edges, what will happen is we would be fixing these two, and we would also skip one more vertex here. So overall we would be having only x minus 3 vertex. And for how many edges this would happen? This would happen for example, here we were having total number of x minus 2 vertex, x minus 2 vertex, which would form x minus 1 edges, and one edge is already covered, so we will have overall x minus 2 edges, which will be from the second onwards. I mean, apart from the first edge, there will be total x minus 2 edges which can form x minus 3 triangles each of them. So we can simply multiply. So this is the answer that we can get if we find all the left ones, that means those are unblocked. So this is one case where we pick these two black ones adjacent to each other. What will happen once we pick somewhere around, let's say once is one black colored is here at 6 and other one is at 1. So let's talk about that case. So now let's consider this more generic case where these two black box, these two black balls or vertices being distance apart from each other instead of being adjacent to each other as we saw in the previous example. So what I'm trying to suggest here is we can always think in terms of like dividing them in left and right half, and once we find out the number of vertices in the left half and the number of vertices in the right half, we can still use the same approach that we did to find the answer in the left half individually and then the right half, and we can just simply add. So what we saw that if we have some vertices, let's say for example, if this one is x and this one is the number of vertices in this half is x and in this half it is y, then what would be the answer? The answer for the left one would be, as we saw, that x minus 2 plus it would be x minus 3 multiplied by x minus 2. All right, and similarly we can just add this to our answer, y minus 2 plus y minus 3 multiplied by y minus 2. All right, and now are these the only triangles that we can form? So the answer is no. We can also form a few more triangles here, because now we have divided into two parts, so we can pick one edge from here. Let's say for example, if we pick 8, 9 here, we can pick certain number of vertices from the second half as well to form number of triangles, as previously we were picking only the only the left vertices on each half individually. We can also choose vertices from the cross half, so we can pick, say for example, how many edges we can form here. So we have x number of vertices, so we can form x minus 1 edges here as we know, and how many vertices we can pick from here is y. So we can form total x minus 1 multiplied by y vertices here. Also similarly, we can form certain number of edges here and we could pick all these x vertices here, so that would be y minus 1 multiplied by x. And now that this is the answer that we are looking for, so this total would be the number of triangles that we can form. And now let me show you my code so that you can have a better understanding of how we can implement this. All right, so this is my code, so let me just walk you through this one. So first thing that I had done is found out the number of vertices on each half, and this is how we can do. Let's say this is A and this is B, then the number of vertices here would be B minus A minus 1. So if you see 6 minus 1, it would be 5, and 5 minus 1 would be 4. So we can find out the number of vertices here. And if we found out the number of vertices here, we know that 2 are here. So total N minus the number of vertices we found out here, which is, let's say for example, Y, and minus 2 would be the number of vertices on X, on the left side. So that is what I've done. So yeah, n minus x minus 2 is for the right half, or you can choose x, you can give either of them any value. And then I have initialized my answer, and then I'm just to avoid getting negative values, I have taken this is very important check that you must also do, otherwise you might get wrong answers. So this one is for calculating individual triangles, these two parts are to calculate the triangles that we can form by taking individually the left and right half, and these are the ones which you can form by first taking edges from left half that has x, and then taking the angles vertices from the right half here, the vice versa, and we keep on adding each numbers to our answer, and in the end we'll return our answer or print our answer. So yep, I hope I was able to explain you guys properly. If there is anything that you want me to discuss, or if there is anything which is unclear, or any feedback or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. And do check out my channel where I have solved multiple similar problems or even more interesting problems from bunch of different platforms. And if you like my work, please do subscribe to my channels. Thanks again guys for watching this video.